Hello guys, this is Dalaran's Movies, and today I will be giving you the lore of Dalaran, covering the kingdom and the city and the various changes over the years. So, without further ado, let's get into the lore. Few thousand years ago, almost all of the humans were united under the banner of the Empire of Arator. However, after they defeated the trolls, the power of the Empire started to decline. Soon enough, many new smaller city-states were created, with Dalaran being one of the most prominent ones. Dalaran was created by human wizards that were tired of the restraints they had within Arator, so they decided to create their own city, where they hoped to use magic with much more freedom. After it was constructed, the city became greater than the founders originally expected, as more and more magicians all over the continent started joining, turning Dalaran into a hub for all of those interested in magic. What made the city-state strong, apart from just the people, was that it was built atop a massive ley line, allowing the wizards to control great arcane power. As the new nation evolved, they needed a ruling body, and for some time the Magocrat lords were in charge, until they were later replaced by the Council of Six. During the reign of the Magocrats initially, the first big issue arose, and that was the overuse of magic, because even though they did wish to practice magic with complete freedom, they couldn't really do that because the use of arcane constantly drew in more and more Burning Legion agents. Fearing that the capital of Arator, Strom, would take action against them because they're endangering the world, and that the peasants would revolt, they quickly found a solution. With the help of the elves who actually taught them magic, the Council of Tirisfal was created that evolved over time, but the practice was very much the same. Powerful wizards would form a council and channel their own power into a guardian who served as a conductor for the council's magic, and the guardian would fight the invading threat face to face. This solution worked well for over 2,000 years, and with the Guardian's protection, the wizards were able to continue the work and constantly improve Dalaran. While not particularly a large city, it was beautiful for its size with its towering spires, the Violet Citadel, and many libraries, research chambers, and inns. At its peak, Dalaran established a strong friendship with Silvermoon, and even though the humans were the main race, elves and later even gnomes, dwarves and goblins would come to reside in Dalaran. All was well for a very long time, but with the second war some 30 years ago, the fall of the city as we knew it was on its way. During the Orc invasion, Dalaran had joined the alliance that was fighting the Horde, but the danger to the city would only come after the war was over. The Death Knight Terran Gorfind, aided by Deathwing, infiltrated the Arcane Vault in order to steal the Eye of Dalaran, which was a very powerful artifact, and with its use, the world of Outland was completely shattered. However, this was only the beginning of troubles, as during the Scourge corruption of Lordaeron, Dalaran was for the first time directly under siege. Jaina Proudmoore, who studied under Antonidas, who was the leader of the city-state at the time, took many citizens and fled to Kalimdor, while Antonidas and many other mages stood against Ardis and the Scourge. They put up quite a resistance, but eventually they were overran, and Ardis was able to acquire the Book of Medivh, which would later be used to summon the demon commander Archimonde, and Archimonde, shortly after being teleported, completely destroyed the entire city with his magic, leaving only rubble behind. The ruins were later shortly under the control of the Grand Marshal Geritos, and sometime after that, the surviving mages finally decided to take their home back. They mustered a force as much as they could and managed to get a hold of the ruins, and after that they created a giant glowing shield that would protect them while they worked to rebuild Dalaran. It took a lot of time and effort, but eventually the city was brought to its former glory. During the campaign in Northrend, the mages of Dalaran decided to elevate the city with magic and transport it to the Crystal Song Forest in order to counter the Lich King and the Blue Dragon threat. A giant crater was left in the place where it once stood, and the entire city with its sewers and everything was now floating in the sky. This was a crucial time for Dalaran, as with the leadership of Ronin, it became a neutral city, giving access to both the Alliance and the Horde. The Sanctuary proved to be of great significance to both the defeat of the Blue Dragonflight and ultimately the defeat of the Lich King. In the following years, the city was on the rise, but its neutrality would be shaken by aggressive actions of the new Warchief, Garrosh. As Garrosh was bent on conquering the whole of Kalimdor, starting out with Jaina's own city, Terramor, she requested the aid of Dalaran. Ronin, as the leader, was very reluctant, as he didn't want to bring the city into the middle of a war, but the council ultimately decided to provide assistance in defending Terramor, and in this defense, Ronin sacrificed himself in order to localize the blast of the mana bomb, leaving Dalaran leaderless. Later, Jaina would become the new leader of the council, and at this point, she was very much in bad relations with the Horde. To make matters even worse, Garrosh used the Blood Elves, who were at the time neutral, in order to steal an artifact known as the Divine Bell from Darnassus by using Dalaran portals. This led to a serious conflict and the exile and imprisonment of the Blood Elves and the abolishment of the city's neutrality. Today, with the fall of Garrosh and the Legion invasion, the relations have changed quite a bit, but not much is certain. Dalaran has been moved from Northrend to the Broken Isles in order to counter the Burning Legion, and we do know that the city will once again be a hub and a crucial base for both the Alliance and the Horde. The fate of the Blood Elves in Dalaran is uncertain, but the council does vote in favor for them to return, which forces Jaina to storm out, leaving the leadership to Khadgar. The plot is yet to unravel and much is to be expanded in the new expansion, but one thing is certain, and that is that Dalaran will once again be of crucial importance. Alright, and that is all I have for this video. Do leave your thoughts and suggestions, and do subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, and also like the video as it really helps out and keeps all the content going. Thanks a lot for taking the time out of the day to watch this video, and see you next time.